When people think of grizzly bears, they think of a big, bloodthirsty killing machine.
Just a few hours ago, one of the campers here was mauled to death by a grizzly.
Very quick, it was snap, 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 snap. This can't be happening. She was trying to rip me out of the tent. I felt my bones break, I heard them break. Then I started to scream for help. Just total terror. I wasn't ready to go.
Oh boy.
Isn't that right, bud? I see grizzly bears differently. I see them as emotional creatures, very intelligent.
Good boy.
They're curious, they're inquisitive.
Good boy.
It's a very, very fragile and very, very precarious situation that they're in right now.
Good
and just
boy.
A little bit more of climate change or a little bit more loss of habitat could lead to their extinction.
Take a look at this. There is no better bear real estate on Earth. Grizzlies once roamed through virtually all of the United States. Not anymore. These days, Yellowstone is one of their final frontiers. However, even here, their future is anything but certain.
Fear is one of their number one enemies. Why protect something that you're afraid of? If the people of the world don't want grizzly bears, they won't be here anymore.
I've come to the wildest corner of America's West. Here, wild beasts rule the road. And the grizzly bear roams free, but not entirely unfettered.
Yeah, the Yellowstone grizzly essentially lives on an island surrounded by human development. And there's ways that we can live our lives with these bears around us where we can coexist peacefully.
Not quite like you though, right?
Not quite like me, no, mine's a unique situation.
Few people understand bears better than American naturalist Casey Anderson.
What a good boy.
Little wonder when his best friend is a grizzly called Brutus.
Oh, smash.
Casey and Brutus live in Montana, on the edge of Yellowstone National Park. They met 8 years ago when Brutus was a cub facing an uncertain future. If a place couldn't be found for him in a circus or a zoo, he was going to be put down.
Brutus was born at a wildlife park that was overpopulated. And captive breeding is really a dead-end street. They can never go back into the wild. It'd be wonderful if you could release some of these bears back into the wild, but you can't.
Good boy!
They're one animal that's captivated me. I mean, they're so much like us in so many ways. You see that emotion, you see that intelligence, and I just learn constantly every day from Brutus something different.
I'm meeting him on the outside of a flimsy wire fence that Brutus believes is electrified.
Good!
Yeah.
What a good boy!
There is some power in those feet.
He stands 2.5 meters tall, weighs 400 kilos, and possesses a wicked handshake.
Good boy!
That is incredible.
And Brutus is kind of the real-life 900-pound teddy bear, and everybody wants to hug him and love him. And it's a really great way to turn the tides from that misconception of fear just to show the other side of the bear through Brutus.
Look at all this. You're 8 years old, what a good boy.
They've been together since 2002, oh, and every birthday is
there.
A celebration.
Show everybody what you
presents
got.
Are unwrapped.
Get it, go ahead, get it. Someone!
Oh, and treats devoured.
Oh, get it. Good boy, yeah, you hit the jackpot, buddy, good job.
But then Brutus has himself been a gift.
With this relationship, there's so many things I can do that I could never do with a wild grizzly. I mean, we test bear-proof containers and electric fences, things that save people's lives out there in the wild.
Besides public service announcements,
as you can see, we're on a movie set here demonstrating why it's so important to keep a clean camp in grizzly country. Big Brutus has also taken to the big screen. And when he's not making movies, he's playing matchmaker.
Well, the bear was a package deal that came with a guy.
Hollywood actress Missy Pyle, who played the perfectionist mother on Willy Wonka, was the perfect match for a man and his bear.
You don't say.
They hooked up on the set of a film, Pretty Ugly People, where Brutus was her co-star.
Oh boy.
Let's be honest, it didn't really matter what you looked like because you had a sexy bear. You know what I'm saying?
That's good, right?
You're sharing with Missy.
Missy has married me and married the bear, essentially, with that.
Brutus was even best man at their wedding.
Is that a little strange?
Well, when he told me that he wanted to have him as a best man, I thought, I was like, don't you have, you know, like you have three brothers, can't you? He's like, well, he's my best friend.
Good boy, oh boy. Good
and like
boy.
All good mates, on a hot day, they love sharing a cold bevy.
He does like beer. I think it would take quite a bit to get him intoxicated, but we get him a couple beers here and there.
Wouldn't you want a beer if you were a bear? I mean, come on. He's a bear that was born in captivity, so he can't ever be released into the wild.
I mean, in a perfect world, there'd be no captive grizzly bears. But we don't live in that world. It's his only option. And I have one of the biggest responsibilities in the world in giving him the best life possible. And I try every day. And I find that I'm doing the right thing. He's happy. And he loves it. And as long as he continues to love his life and his relationship, then I see no harm in it at all.
Good boy, that feel good.
It's quite something to watch. Man and gentle giant.
Oh boy.
Having bonded virtually from Brutus's birth, there's an ease about their relationship which is astounding when you consider just how dangerous this friendship could be.
My father is an insurance agent, and I told him about Casey, and he was like, Missy, he always used to tell me this about driving a motorcycle. He'd say, Missy, it's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. And then when I told him that Casey had asked me to marry him, he said, Missy, you know it's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when with that grizzly bear.
That's something that you always got to keep in mind. Regardless of Brutus's personality, he's still a grizzly bear.
Yeah.
So it's very important that we keep that in mind because grizzly bears are capable of killing you like that.
911, where's your emergency?
Hi, I'm in Cook City right now, and we had someone that's been attacked and bitten pretty badly by a bear.
And here's where our story took a dramatic turn. During our filming, Yellowstone was the site of a ferocious grizzly attack, one of the worst recorded. What we do know is that the campground's closed off. It was evacuated overnight. There are armed park rangers inside searching for that grizzly bear right now. A mother and her cubs went on a rampage, stalking three separate campsites in the dark of the night. One man was killed, his body partially eaten. Two other tourists were savagely mauled.
She was hunting. She had gone what they call predatory.
She was hunting you.
Mm-hmm. There was no warning. I just had a sudden sense something's not right, and then...
Deb Friel was on a fishing holiday with her husband. She was asleep in her tent when the bears attacked.
I'm telling myself, this can't be happening. I'm being eaten by a bear. It was very quick. It was snap, 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 snap. I was thinking about my kids and my family. I wasn't ready to go. So I was going to do whatever I had to do to make that stop. And that was why I did what I did. I decided I didn't have another way out other than to play dead. So I just went totally limp.
And that's what saved you?
That's what saved my life.
She will have a healthy dose of fear for the rest of her life, and it's justified. I can't think of a more nightmarish thing than a grizzly bear coming through your tent in the middle of the night, waking you up and attacking you. But the food sources are running out. And we see now that bears are choosing to interact with humans and looking at actually eating humans for food.
What may be driving the bears into a feeding frenzy is this tiny beetle, which has destroyed thousands of hectares of the whitebark pine tree, the grizzlies' staple food. Extreme cold normally kills the beetles, but recent warmer winters caused by climate change have seen them thrive.
This tree is 300 years old, probably seen many a rough winter, but now these little beetles are killing it. You know, the little pine cone that comes from this tree is essential for the grizzly bear to eat. Without that food source, what's happening is they're going down the mountain, going to the campgrounds.
We've basically taken over their habitat. We've eliminated a lot of their food sources, so they're just trying to survive. But unfortunately, we can't really have humans on the bear's menu.
The camper killed by the mother grizzly was this father of four. The bear was later caught and euthanized. Her three cubs will now be raised in a zoo.
Actually, I wouldn't mind seeing them.
Why?
It's not the cubs' fault. And I don't hold any animosity to the bear or the cubs. It's not their fault. It's just the way it is. I know those cubs have tasted humans, and they learn from their mother everything. And they learn from their mother how to kill people, so they can't be out in the wild.
You're a survivor, aren't you?
Yep, I am that.
In towns surrounding Yellowstone, there have been calls for more bears to be hunted. Calls to cull. Casey Anderson shudders at the prospect of a grizzly open season.
If people got to know bears, like I have with Brutus, they would never shoot them. It'd be like shooting your brother. The grizzlies need help. They make decisions based on comfort and emotion and the path of least resistance and a lot of things like that. They're very similar to us. And if we look at them in the light for what they are, it'll help us understand them so we can coexist with them better.
So what about the future for you and Brutus?
Well, Brutus is only 8 years old. I'm 34. And Brutus will live to be 40. So we're really gonna grow gray together. And I mean, I really can count on Brutus, my best friend, being with me for the rest of his life, the rest of my life.
So you're gonna grow old together?
Absolutely. There's an obvious, huge risk in working with a grizzly bear. And there may be a day, by accident, a wild grizzly will kill me, or Brutus will kill me because I made a mistake. But it'll be from my mistake. And I have to make sure I don't make that mistake every day.